ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Rage TV. I am Mark Gray. We are coming to you from the great city of Baltimore, Maryland. As we inch ever closer to the Shane Shamrock Memorial Cup, every man in the locker room is doing their best to outshine their competitors. And no one else is better than that than my guest at this time. Since debuting in MCW a short time ago, he has laid a path of very impressive victories. So, with a very special message, please welcome Napalm Bomb. Now, Napalm, I know you had a few words for everyone at home and everyone here in the arena.
And ladies and gentlemen, I deserve that. Ladies and gentlemen, I came out here to talk about something serious. Now, my name is Derek Green. Some of you may know me as Napalm. But I've came out here to talk about a very serious situation. Now, as you may know, watching television, listening to the radio, going online, that we finally got the man that is responsible for the greatest tragedy in American history. We finally got the man that's responsible for murdering hundreds of people. We finally got the man, Osama bin Laden. Yes, yes. Yes. And I couldn't be happier to be an American today. You know, just like you, I had family, friends, who all went over to Afghanistan, Pakistan, and fought this war. Some of them did not come back. But I am proud to say I am an American. God bless America. Now, ladies and gentlemen, will you help me bring out the commissioner of MCW? Jimmy Cicero.
First of all, you know what? I couldn't be more proud to shake your hand. Huh? What do you say for Napalm, huh? I agree 100% with everything you just said. I couldn't be more proud to be an American right now. And the news that we all received last week, I'll tell you what, or earlier this week, I'll tell you what, Osama bin Laden, he's dead.
Yeah!
Huh? So I want each and every one of you to please stand up and join me as we all together as Americans say the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. Hey, and you know what? I want to bring out two other friends of mine right now. They were in the back, and they wanted to come out and say a word or two with you guys. Come on, Country Strong. Come on out. Actually, three friends, because they got Chastity, the beautiful Chastity, with them. Huh?
How you doing, sweetie?
How y'all doing? Yeah!
What's going on?
How you doing, sir?
What do you say, big dog? Yeah! Boy!
Let's go, baby. We just want to let you know we got your back anytime you need it. Hoss myself.
Thank you.
That's right.
Thank you. We got your back, bro. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. There you go.
Now, like I said before, the reason we're here in MCW is for one reason only, and that's to get the tag team championship. It doesn't matter who we have to go through, what tag team's out there, we're going to take the tag team gold home.
Yeah, now, I tell you right now, boy, I'm happier than a tornado in a trailer park to be right here in MCW. And I tell you, boy, we gonna walk through these boys. We just gonna stomp a mud hole in them and walk it dry, baby. Walk it dry. How you mama now?
Giddy up.
Well, there you have it, folks. Kevin Chesney, Haas Haygood, Patriots, just like Napalm Bomb. We will be right back. Gentlemen, my next guest is a former friend of Napalm Bomb. He brought him into MCW. Probably does not want to talk about that, but let's find out what he does want to talk about. Please welcome Black Wall Street with Drolix and Streets. I'll just hand it over. How about that? That works for us.
What's up, MCW? Shut up! Let me introduce you to a man that I went back to the streets to get. A man that I know that's gonna have my back. Why? Because he's about what I'm about. This, all this paper, that's what we're here to get. Let me introduce you to a man, the man, Marcus Street. Black Wall Street, baby. That's what it is. That's what we do. First order of business is this MCW Ringling Brothers crap that's going on, this dark carnival. I haven't forgot what you boys did to me last time. I ain't forgot by a long shot. See you later, Booger Wolves. Come on, Pep, do your job.
Well, there's nothing else to say after that.
What's up? This is Kirby Mack, one half of Team Action, and you're watching Rage TV. Guaranteed satisfaction.
Yo, son. Fed Up is in the house once again. You know what I'm saying? My boy G-Fed.
My man C-Fezzle.
Yo, you know what I want to talk about right now? If you're getting tired of sitting in the audience and you want to jump in the ring, come to the place where the pros train. Gilbert's Pro Wrestling Academy, son. You know what I'm saying? Give my man Gilbert a call. 410-969-8077. Ha 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 ha! Yay, son.
Oh, what a pleasure indeed it was to return to Baltimore, to return to Maryland, and experience Maryland Championship Wrestling, MCW. There ain't no better around, believe you me.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's been a bit of a love triangle in MCW as of late, revolving around our Rage TV champion, Ronnie Zuko, his main squeeze, Candy, and the newcomer, Jesse K. Go ahead and call out the champ now and see if we can get to the bottom of this. Ronnie Zuko, it looks like your entourage has gotten one more bigger since the...
Hey, beat it, Slim Pickens. I got this. Look at me right here, Slick. What you're looking at right now is the most dominating television champion that this company will ever see. And while I got this opportunity, what I would like to do is thank Jessica for everything you've done. You've been a wonderful assistant to me, and I appreciate you.
Excuse me. Thank you. Ronnie, I want to thank you. To be honest, I think we are the greatest team that MCW has ever, ever seen.
Let me tell you something. The next time you snatch something out of my hand, I'm gonna slap you right in the face.
Let me tell you something. If any slapping's going on out here, I'm gonna be the one that's doing it. Do you understand me? Both of you, get it together. Hey, Slick, hit my music and get me an opponent so I can show you how bad I really am.
Well, there you have it. More questions than answers. It is music.
Well, you gotta give it to him, man. He is the Rage TV champion. How is everybody doing out there? This is Dwayne Gilbert Gill, and this is another episode of Rage TV, baby. Tonight I got Pete with me doing some color commentary because Mark Bray, I'll tell you what, the busy bee that he is, he's down there trying to get all the news and all the scoops and everything on everybody. So he's got a million interviews tonight. So tonight, Pete, how you doing, buddy?
Great to be here with you, Dwayne. Hot action here on Rage TV. Really excited to see what's going to happen here tonight. I tell you what, Ronnie Zuko, you got to wonder. I may not agree with all his tactics, but the guy's got two women by his side, and that's just poison if you ask me.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. And like you were saying about slapping, I'll be honest with you. I think he would slap him.
I tell you what, I wouldn't put it past him. I've seen the guy in action, and he's definitely all about himself. See, he's out there, he's toying with the fans right now, and there's no love lost right there with Ronnie Zuko between the fans, you can tell that.
Oh, you can say that again, but again, he is the Rage TV champion, and he is the baddest man in MCW right now, baby, as far as Rage TV goes.
Well, you know, to be the man, you got to beat the man. Right now, he is holding the strap. So
ain't that the truth?
Be interested to see what he does here tonight and who Ronnie's taking on here in this.
But I tell you what, they got two beautiful women with him. Mm, dang, man. Oh, he's taking on the youngster, man. He's taking on the youngster, baby. RK Blues.
RK Blues, up-and-coming wrestler here in Rage TV. And really...
Third generation wrestler.
Third generation, and that's impressive to say the least. Ricky Blues, his father, established well here in the state of Maryland. Looking forward to see what the youngster's picked up from his dad.
Oh, yeah. This guy's got some talent, I'll tell you. But, you know, he makes the rookie mistakes. He's still young.
Ronnie's definitely giving it to him before we go. A little verbal tactics back and forth here, a little game plan.
Oh, man, what a feather in his cap would that be if he beat Ronnie Zuko?
Absolutely.
Oh, man, Ronnie putting a wrench on that arm, isn't he?
Hey, but he's tying it in hard. Referee checking it out.
Oh, look at the bruise. Forward roll, reverse roll, over to the ropes, does another flip. Whoa, ah! Oh. How you like that, Ronnie?
Tell you what, he's going to keep the champion on his toes throughout this match. You can see this youngster is aggressive, wants to get after it.
Oh, yeah. But you will see. I know Ronnie Zuko. I've been around the block once or twice with Ronnie Zuko, and the man is a bad man. That's all that I can say about him.
Well, I tell you what, RK's got a lot to deal with right here. You know, he's got two ladies outside the ring. He's got to keep his eye on two while he's trying to work the champion. That is no easy task.
Well, it's easy to keep your eye on the girls. It's just hard to wrestle at the same time.
Ronnie there showing a bit of confidence as he getting ready to go over across the ropes. Stepping over here.
Whoa! Oh, hip toss attempt. Block. Oh, did you see that?
Very nice. Oh, look at that. The kid's up quick. He's got some fast feet. right back on top of Ronnie really quick.
Staying on that arm, man. You can tell his dad taught him to take a body part and work it to death.
Absolutely. Yeah. Ronnie looks a little tired, but gasping a little bit of wind here with the youngster.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, there is no substitute for youth, that's for sure.
Absolutely, absolutely. Got him tied up in the corner there. Referee making the count. Oh, miss.
Come on, Blues. Oh, chop. Chop. Look at him. He's whipping Ronnie in now. Oh, no, he's nice. Not.
Nice reversal. Oh.
Oh, no. Somebody's going to be in the world. Oh. Look at that. Ronnie putting his own spin on that move.
Ronnie calling out to the crowd, toying with them at best. He's not looking for any respect out of the crowd.
Look at him, man. He is cocky. He's good and knows it, though. That's the problem.
Yeah, I tell you what, Zuko's going to be dangerous here. He's carrying the strap. He's got two strong individuals outside there watching over his every move, making sure that nobody comes in behind and gets a cheap shot on him. Oh, nice shot right there by Ronnie.
And, of course, you know Jessie Kay. She was brought in and taught by J.P. Callahan. So she's one of the worst out there as far as women can go.
Oh, come on.
Look, what I tell you right there.
This is completely uncalled for. It's unacceptable. You know,
yeah, look, but you got Candy out there. Stop that. See, Candy believes in, you know, if you're going to beat somebody, beat them fair and square.
I have to agree with you there. Dwayne and Ronnie grabbing him up. See where he's going to go with it from here. And strong shot.
Oh, man. I tell you what, I've been on the end of a few of them. They really hurt.
I tell you, you got to admire, though, Ricky Blues is fighting it. And he's looking for every little bit that he can pull from deep inside of him to pull this match out and not giving in easily.
Ooh. God.
He is just relentless right now. There's the whip.
Oh, look at the youngster. Yeah, one, two. Oh.
Two, a little bit past two. Looks like a 2.5 if you ask me.
You know, I know we're supposed to be, you know, non-biased, but you can't help it, man. You got to root for a young kid like this.
I tell you, it's guys like this that you look and hopefully that, you know, through time and putting their training in and developing their skills that you see them on, you know, shows like our Shane Shamrock Memorial Cup, which is coming up. And this would be a great chance for somewhere down the road for this kid to really make a name for himself with a big win here.
You know, that's true. That's true. That man. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Whoa. Does a handstand, grabs him with his legs, and then flips him over, and then gives him an enziguri.
I tell you what, you got to be impressed.
One, two. Ah.
Very quick feet. Got to be impressed there. He's definitely staying on top of the champion. Trying not to give him a breath there.
Big old suplex on the champion. Come on, Blue, stay with him. Don't give him a chance to rest. Uh-oh. He might be going to the well too much. Oh, there's Jesse Kay. Look at this. Look what I tell you, man.
You just knew that wasn't going to happen.
That's that teachings of J.P. Callahan, I'm telling you. Telling you that.
I'll tell you what, it's impressive to see the least that she's determined to keep that belt on Ronnie that she emphatically claims that she helped him get.
Well, she did. There's no doubt about it. Oh! Oh, did you see that? I think the champion took part of that shot. Look at him. He's knocked out himself, the champion is. He can't even get up.
Good morning, good afternoon, and good night. That's three, and the champion goes over once again.
That's it, though. One, two, three, and that's it, baby.
So, winner of the match, your MCW Rage TV champion, Ray.
Well, Pete, what do you think, man? The Rage TV champion. There he is. Look, I tell you, man, he knocked himself out on that move.
I'll tell you what, yeah, it definitely took a lot out of both of them, but you got to be impressed with the fact that, you know, Ronnie was able to get in with this quick up-and-comer. Definitely a lot of tenacity in RK Blue for being brand new to the scene and really driving at home. And looks like you got something going on here. I got Mark Gray down at the Rage TV interview. Let's go down to Mark and see what he's got going. Looks like Zachary Shane down there with us.
Yeah, but we got to keep it on the Rage TV. Whoa, took it off the champ. There's RK right there. What? Why is he picking on RK? He just had a match.
You're young. You're hungry, but there's just one thing that I've been dying to ask you. What's it like to be known around Maryland as a loser? You know, RK, I come from the genetics of an Adonis. You come from the genetics of garbage. And you know what they say? The apple doesn't fall
far from the tree. Just like you, your father was always a loser here in Maryland.
I'll tell you what, I'm out here to make my dad proud, and I know I'm making these people proud.
RK, you know what? Just to prove a point to you, to all of them, and your dad sitting at home, what a loser you are, next week on this show, I'm challenging you to a loser wears this shirt until they can win a match in MCW. And you will be known as a loser, just as I said.
I accept your challenge.
Well, I'm glad you do. I'll see you next week.
Well, there you go, folks. Next week on Rage TV, Zachary Shane, RK Blues, loser wears the shirt. We'll be right back.
I'm the Boogeyman. And you're watching Rage TV.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome to the Green Room in Dundalk, Maryland. Welcome to MCW Extreme Measures. Lands hard on Callahan. That guy is crazy. A cerebral psychopath is what I would use to describe Joshua Daniels.
Oh my God, off the top rope, baby.
That's about 15 feet in the air.
Only in MCW.
The Curse and the Gift. Earlier tonight, Commissioner Cicero put the stipulations for this matchup. He said that if Zachary Shane is unable to defeat Cobian, then come the main event with Tyler Hilton and Ryan McBride, both Joe Hamilton and Zachary Shane are not allowed at ringside. Drolix has a mean streak a mile wide. You can just look on his face. Former member, former founding member, in his words, of the Hit Squad, now on his own.
In his words, in his put words, the Hit in Hit Squad.
Fed up now, as JP Callahan says, you want a
match? Oh! Who's the legal man?
I don't think the referee knows any better than we do. And ladies and gentlemen, that is called tag team teamwork right there. Commissioner Cicero did the right thing by appointing Bruiser as the referee. Wait a second.
What? Oh, the Bruiser's back to his old vicious ways. I told you he was coming back.
Unbelievable action here, only the way that MCW does it.
Hey now, how you mom and them? I'm Hoss Haygood. I'm one part of Country Strong, newest tag team on the block here in MCW. And you watching the show that all good country people watch, Rage TV.
This is Nui Tofiga, and you're watching Rage TV.
This is Ronnie Zuko, the Rage TV champion with Jessica, and you're watching Rage TV.
All right, we're back, everybody. Here we are, Rage TV Hall. And yeah, I'm sorry, Arena. I always make that mistake. Here we are. We got Black Wall Street here coming out. Drolix coming out with all that green back. Tell you what.
Tell you what, him and Streets, this is his new partner here as part of Black Wall Street. You know, Drolix is trying to teach him the ways of how he wants to take it to the mat.
You hear that? What is a boogaloo? What is a boogaloo?
I tell you what, I'm not affiliated with that. I could Wikipedia get back to you, Dwayne, but right now I'm ready to get a little bit of the action.
Entering the ring.
In the ring, we got Champion Payne and Justin Cody getting ready to take on
West Baltimore.
Streets
Black Wall Street. Drolix.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look. There's one of our big fans right there, baby.
No pun intended, of course. We got senior referee D. Edwards calling the match here tonight, so this ought to be interesting to see how this goes down.
Oh, yeah. But this Drolix, you know, I've been trying to get an interview with him and asked him where, you know, he's from and everything. I said, you're from Baltimore, ain't you? You know, Baltimore, Maryland? He says, no, I'm from Murderland. That's where I'm from, Murderland.
Well, the guy's got issues. There's no doubt about that. But let's see what happens here as Streets jumps in the ring, gets things kicked off with Justin Corbin.
I tell you what, he found something in Streets here, man, because he says Streets is straight from the same bloodline he's from, you know. Right from the heartland.
It ought to be interesting to see this. You know, very easily could break out into a street fight. We don't know, no pun intended, of course, with Streets being his partner, but I definitely see this being some quick action here right now.
Oh, yeah.
A little too strong for you there, Street.
Playing to the referee about a little hair pull. Not sure if that actually happened. Their lockup's a little bit challenging for Streetville here, but let's see what we can do with it.
Does he have hair under there?
Tell you what, Drolics, you got to see something this kid to bring him on and get him here on Rage TV on episode tonight. Nice, probably strong punch. Quick jabs to the face.
And pay him all the money he's paying him.
Well, I'm not privy of all that information to anybody. Oh, here we go. Nice encounter by Street.
Ooh, hard right. Hard right. He's up top. Look how fast he is. Boom! Did you see how fast he got up at top rope?
Quick roll, quick count. Only a one. Oh, tell you what, this kid Street's got some strong right hands.
Yeah, but did you see that reversal? Corbin caught him off the top rope and slammed him. That was good.
Let's see what we got here. I'm curious to see how long Drolix is going to let this go before he looks to tag into his partner. Nice duck under.
Ooh, a boot to the belly. Oh, what a DDT.
Street's telling the ref he's not worth it there. Definitely has a lot of cockiness to him for being one of the first few times here on Rage TV. So you got to figure that's one of the things Drolix saw in him is his confidence level, which may come off as cockiness to these fans.
Oh, a cockiness? Come on, that's all it is, man. That's Black Wall Street there. I'll tell you what, there's some mean boys there.
Oh, big Alpha. Very nicely played. And Street's letting the crowd know exactly what he has done. Looks like he's motioning into the belt there. Is he talking tag team championship already, Dwayne?
No way.
Tag in here to Drolix, and that's a little bit of double team going on here.
Say what you want about the Holy Rollers, but Streets, I don't think you want any of them boys yet.
Drolix still out there talking to the fans, letting them know what's going on, and I'm seeing the carnival coming in backside there, Dwayne.
Was that the carnival I saw out there?
I'm pretty sure I saw it.
You know, they're a strange bunch, but you gotta love them, man. Gotta love them.
They come out of nowhere, just appear on the scene. It's pretty interesting. Drolix caught right there. Quick tag out. Champ Champagne coming in for the action here.
There they are, ringside right there, yep. Champ Champagne gives him a heck of a tackle. Drolix takes it.
Nice step over.
Oh, blocked that hip toss and gave him one of his own.
Not really sure what the Dark Carnival was doing there. We got an inset. Guy with those eyes is scary. Nice dropkick.
Well, Oliver Grimsley, you got to give it to him. He's a strange character, but my God. He's so cool. Look at him. Look at him. He's so cool.
Poke the eyes. Definitely rough.
Oh, always a short. Always a shortcut. Oh, my God.
That was a fucking close on here. Two. Oh, only a two count.
He told me that was called the Murderland Express.
You know what's interesting, Wayne, is you know, even with this little activity going outside, Drolix is remaining focused on the match, not getting taken away by what's going on ringside with the carnival, obviously getting an expensive seat for the match. Oh, what a chop.
Oh, I mean a vicious chop.
I'll tell you what, Drolix is fascinated with that person at ringside, one of those fans. He is just giving it to him in between everything he's got going on here. Shots here, champ fighting back.
But not for long. I'm telling you, Drolix is vicious.
Yeah, you got Justin there trying to power his teammate a little bit of energy here from the fans.
Oh! Ooh, sidewalk slam air, baby.
Oh, painful. Only a two.
Oh,
what do we got going on here?
What's Oliver Grimsley doing? What's he
up
doing?
Up on the apron. Giving him a
Oh, isn't that nice? He gave him a... Oh! Oh, no, look! One, two, three! Oh, oh, no! Oh, man, that's awesome!
Sweet Mother Mabel, what just happened?
That is great!
The balloon was full filled with excrement, popped in Drolix's face, obviously blinded by it. We got a quick pin here by the team of Champ Champagne and Justin Ford on Rage TV. Definitely a setback.
Oh, yeah. They're happy as anything. Look at them. Out slapping hands and everything. But I'll be honest with you. Somebody going to pay for that. I know Drolix. That isn't going over easy.
MCW. We are Maryland Wrestling.